Hello class 9. Today I will explain you chapter number 4, operators. In this chapter I will tell you about the operator, types of operators, increment, decrement, system out print and system out println, new operator, dot operator and ternary operator. And we will do some questions based on the increment, decrement and the use of different types of operators. Let's start. Unit 4, operators in Java. First, Java operators. Operators are used to perform operations on variables and values. In the example below, we use the plus operator to add together to two values. For example, int x, and these are the two values, and this is the operator. Although the plus operator is often used to add together two values, like in the example above, it can also be used to add together a variable and a value. Means we can add x plus 50 or a variable and another variable, x plus y. Example, int sum 1, 100 plus 50, it became 150, and 100 plus 50 int sum 2, we can write this sum 1 plus 250. This is the variable 1 and this is the value. It will become 400. 150 plus 250 became 400. Now int sum 3, this is the third variable. Sum 2 is first variable, sum 1 is first variable and sum 2 is second variable. So that we will, sum 2 plus sum 2. Sum 2 means 400 plus 400 became 800. Now this is variable and this is also variable. Java divides the operator into the following groups. First is arithmetic operator, assignment operator, comparison operator, logical operator, bitwise operator. Arithmetic operator. Arithmetic operators are used to perform. Now first I am telling you about the arithmetic operators. Arithmetic operators are used to perform common mathematical operations. Means it will do mathematical calculation. Operators and name and description which are related to the arithmetic operators. First arithmetic operator is plus addition. Adds together two values. For example, x plus y. Second, minus subtraction. Subtract one value from another. X minus y. Y subtracted from the x. Third is multiplications. Multiply two values. X multiplied by y. Divide. This is the divide. Division divides one value by another. And division signs represented by a backslash. So, x backslash y means x divided by y. Modulus. This is the percentage sign, but here we will tell the in arithmetic operator it is called modulus. It returns the division remainder. First we will divide x by the y and the remainder is the answer of that data. Plus plus increment increases the value of a variable by 1. Plus plus x means it will increases by 1. If x is 14, then plus 1 x will become 15. Minus minus decrement decreases the value of a variable by 1. Minus minus means if x is equal to 14, then it will minus 1, value will be 20, value will be 30. Now Java assignment operators. Assignment operator are used to assign value of a variable. In the example below, we use the assignment operator equal. Equal sign uses as an assignment value. Assign the value 10 to a variable x. Then we will write like this, int x is equal to 10, because x the value 10 to a variable called x. The addition assignment operator plus adds a value to a variable. Suppose int x is equal to 10. Then x plus is equal to 10 means x value is 10. 10 plus 5 become 15 will be the answer. Now Java comparison operators. कंपैरिजन ऑपरेटर्स आर यूज टू कंपेयर टू वैल्यूज इक्वल्स टू इफ एक्स इक्वल इक्वल वाई मीन्स द वैल्यू ऑफ एक्स इज इक्वल टू द वैल्यू ऑफ वाई नॉट इक्वल्स दिस इज द साइन एक्स नॉट इक्वल इज इक्वल टू वन दिस इज वाई इट मीन्स एक्स इज नॉट इक्वल टू वाई ग्रेटर देन एक्स ग्रेटर देन वाई लेस देन एक्स लेस देन वाई ग्रेटर देन एंड इक्वल टू इट मीन्स एक्स ग्रेटर देन एंड इक्वल टू वाई लेस देन और इक्वल टू इट मीन्स एक्स लेस देन और इक्वल टू वाई नाउ जावा लॉजिकल ऑपरेटर्स लॉजिकल ऑपरेटर आर यूज टू डिटरमाइन द लॉजिक बिटवीन वेरिएबल और वैल्यूज फॉर एग्जाम्पल दिस इज डबल एंड साइन मीन्स लॉजिकल एंड रिटर्न द ट्रू इफ बोथ स्टेटमेंट आर ट्रू सपोज एक्स लेस देन फाइव एंड एक्स लेस देन टेन बोथ स्टेटमेंट आर ट्रू सो दैट दिस इज द लॉजिकल स्टेटमेंट देन दिस मीन्स लॉजिकल और रिटर्न ट्रू इफ वन ऑफ द स्टेटमेंट इज ट्रू दिस इज और इट विल फाइंड द टू वन कंडीशन ट्रू बिटवीन द टू ऑपरेटर्स एक्स लेस देन फाइव और एक्स लेस देन फोर इट विल टेक ट्रू कंडीशन विच विल बी ट्रू इट विल रिटर्न दैट वैल्यू नॉट दिस साइन इज रिप्रेजेंट लॉजिकल नॉट रिवर्स द रिजल्ट रिटर्न फॉल्स इफ द रिजल्ट इज ट्रू एक्स लेस देन फाइव एंड एक्स लेस देन टेन विच कंडीशन विल बी ट्रू दैट विल बी द आंसर द डॉट ऑपरेटर्स ऑल्सो नोन एज सेपरेटर और पीरियड यूज टू सेपरेट अ वेरिएबल और मेथड फ्रॉम अ रेफरेंस वेरिएबल ओनली स्टैटिक वेरिएबल और मेथड कैन एसिड यूजिंग क्लास नेम ऑब्जेक्ट रेफरेंस मेथड नेम आर्ग्यूमेंट लिस्ट द डॉट ऑपरेटर इज यूज फॉर डायरेक्ट मेंबर सिलेक्शन वाय ऑब्जेक्ट नेम इन अदर वर्ड्स वी कैन से इट इज यूज टू एसिड द चाइल्ड ऑब्जेक्ट क्लास नेक्स्ट इज टर्नरी ऑपरेटर इट इज अ पार्ट ऑफ जावाज कंडीशनल स्टेटमेंट एज द नेम टर्नरी सजेस्ट इट इज द ओनली ऑपरेटर इन जावा कंसिस्टिंग ऑफ थ्री ऑपरेंड्स द टर्नरी ऑपरेटर कैन बी थॉट ऑफ एज अ सिंप्लीफाइड वर्जन ऑफ द इफ एल्स स्टेटमेंट विद अ वैल्यू टू बी रिटर्न हेयर वी आर यूजिंग थ्री ऑपरेंड विच इंडिकेट्स दैट एंड क्वेश्चन मार्क साइन इंडिकेट दैट दिस इज द टर्नरी ऑपरेटर साइन जावा टर्नरी ऑपरेटर इज द ओनली कंडीशनल ऑपरेटर दैट टेक्स थ्री ऑपरेंड इट इज अ वन लीनियर रिप्लेसमेंट फॉर इफ देन एल्स स्टेटमेंट व्हेन वी आर यूजिंग इफ देन एल्स वी विल राइट द इंस्ट्रक्शन इन थ्री लाइन्स बट व्हेन वी आर यूजिंग ternary operator in place of if then else statement we will use only one line replacement is there and it is used a lot in java programming we can use the ternary operator in place of if else conditions or even switch conditions using nested ternary operators syntax of java ternary operator is first result equal to this is the test statement And this is the ternary operator value 1 and value 2. Which value will be true? That value will be the output of the, will be the result of the conditions, of the condition which we have used. If test statement is true, then value 1 is assigned to result variable, else value 2 is assigned to result variable. A ternary operator allows you to assign one value to the variable if the condition is true and another value if the condition is false. Means if the value is true, then it give the output in the form of value 1. If the condition is false, then second value will be the answer. Then if else block example from above could now be written as shown in the example below. Suppose we have written var num. Well, var num is equal to 4. Now message, this is the message is equal to, this is message, message is equal to num equal equal 4. That this is the ternary operator. This is write the example. Now I am telling you if we are using ternary operator code to replace the if else code. This is the short program which this is the short code which are using by if else statement. Suppose this is the if, this is the expression which we will use. Curly bracket, number equal to 10, curly bracket close. Next condition else, equal, curly bracket open, number is equal to minus 10. This is the positive number and this is the negative number. Then close. Now we will replace this if else condition, if else code with the ternary operator. In ternary operator, first we will write the number, which will be the result. Number is the result, is equal to expression. The expression which we have written here, that is the expression we will write here. This, now we will write ternary operator. Then expression 1. This is the expression 1 and this is the expression 2. We will write expression 2 here and expression false here. If this is 2, then 10 will be the answer. If this is 2, then minus 10 will be the answer. Example, Java ternary operator. Suppose we are using class operator, public static void main string args, double number minus 5.5 we have taken, string result we will take. Now result is equal to number, this is the expression, number is greater than 0.00. Then this is ternary operator, now it is tell if this is positive or not positive, negative number. This is the first expression, this is the second expression. Now we will print the result, which result will come. The result will come when you return the program, the output will be minus 55 is not positive, because we have taken number is equal to minus 5.5 and we have written the condition number is greater than 0.0, means this condition will be positive, because this is the negative number, so that positive condition will be false. So expression second will be the answer, and number is equal to minus 5.5 and condition is not positive. The output will be 5.5 is not a positive number. Now you can replace multiple lines of code with a single line of code using ternary operator. It makes your code more readable. However, you don't overdo it. For example, you can replace the following code. If expression 1, result is equal to 1, else if expression 2. There are so many, we have using so many if in this program segment. If else expression 2, result will be 2, else if expression 3, result will be 3, otherwise result will be 0. Now here we are using 3 expressions. Result is equal to expression 1, this is expression 1, this expression 1 we will write here. Ternary operator 1, or expression 2, ternary operator 2, then expression 3, ternary operator, then 3. There are 3 conditions we will write. Now we will write this type of program if else code in this ternary operators code. We will change this example into a ternary coding. Now New operator is an operator which denotes a request for memory location allocation on the heap. If sufficient memory is available, new operator initializes the memory and returns the address of the newly allocated and initializing memory to the pointer variable. Means new operator initializes the newly allocated memory. The Java new keyword is used to create an instance of the class. In other words, instantiates a class by allocating memory of a new object and returning a reference to that memory. We can also use the new keyword to create the array object. We will also use new keyword in the when we are declare the array object. That time we can also use new keyword. Now next is, what is the difference between i++ and ++i? Both are increment the number, but ++i increment the number before the current expressions is evaluated. Means we will increase one before the actions, whereas i++ increment the number after the expression is evaluated. Means after the action we will increment plus one here. Now difference between print and println in Java. As we know, in Java these both methods are primarily used to display text from code to console. The prints method simply print text on the console and means simply it will print the text in one line and does not add any new line. While we are using println, it adds new line after print text on console. After print, it will take a new line by using println statement. Hope you all understood this. Now you will read this chapter from your book. If you have any problem, you can ask me through email. I will try to solve your problem. And if you want any program which you can't understand, you will write that program to me by email and I will try to do that program in my upcoming video. Thank you.